The Honourable Member for Minto.
Madam Speaker, addiction does not discriminate. It crosses all geographic, generational, gender, racial, and social economic lines. Substance Use and Addictions Awareness Week should be an attempt to raise awareness about the use of harmful substances within our communities. Manitobans know all too well the harms of addiction. Our province is currently gripped by illegal opioid use and a meth crisis that this government has refused to acknowledge. Meth-related hospital visits, violent incidents in our hospitals and correctional facilities are up by a shocking amount. Communities across Manitoba are reporting an increase in crime, and everyone, including police, community agencies, addictions experts, and others, point to the abuse of methamphetamine. Behind these statistics are people's loved ones. Lives are at stake, and we do need to take strong action to protect them. Addiction is first and foremost a call for help, Madam Speaker. Government has a duty to help answer that call with investments in prevention and treatment, as well as services for mental health and stronger social supports. The best investment we can make is preventing Manitobans from becoming addicted to dangerous drugs like meth. Yet this government has done absolutely nothing in the way of prevention, even as these issues have gripped our province. Today we have an opportunity to bring forward solutions, including but not limited to safe consumption sites that have been shown to work and which enhance the health and safety of our society. Manitobans struggling with mental illness and addictions need timely access to health and social services that meet their unique needs. We need to create healthy and inclusive communities that are given the resources to identify and intervene in mental health and addictions problems early. We also need to address the intersection of addiction and poverty by investing in housing, employment support, and justice. Long-term supports in early addictions intervention and prevention are urgently needed. The previous Minister of Health told me this government has no intention of reporting to Manitobans on its progress on implementing the recommendations of the Virgo Report. I urge this government to reconsider that position. Manitobans need a government that takes this issue seriously. Thank you, Madam.